sakes. We've got Scotch egg, Brazil nuts, satsuma, sausage rolls, twiglets, whatever you want. Whatever you want.
No, you're all right.
They're no, fresh good. Today.
Mind you, that's, is there a toffee coin in here?
Is that your favourite?
Yeah.
That is my favourite toffee
coin. Is it?
Yeah. And there's some after eights.
Oh, bang on. Good man.
Yeah, lovely. What's that deodorant?
I was just trying to get the stench off this jumper. I nicked it.
Is it a Christmas jumper? It is, isn't it? No, no, I mean... You might, yeah, good for you, yeah, lovely, good. No, I love it. I do, I've got my flamenco trousers on.
You have?
Olé!
Good man.
Now, what are you like at Christmas? Do you go crazy? Do you eat loads? Oh, you've eaten a toffee penny.
I have.
Yeah, we'll be back after this break, once he's... You never start a conversation with it and you eat a toffee penny.
Well, I'm
why
so
are you
sorry.
Your clock back?
It's going to take a while, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you know, not, I can't with these teeth.
Of course
I
you
can. Can't, I
it's
can't.
It's your favourite.
It is, I do love a toffee penny. I do. I do. Well, then, OK, then. And now... Well... Oh, my God, this is the worst interview ever!
I'm so sorry.
Because my favourite tradition at Christmas is mistletoe. I love mistletoe, but you're lucky because we haven't got. Oh my God, it's a miracle! All right! You nearly killed one of our guests! Okay, you can get rid of it.
There's no chance, is there?
No, not a toffee penny, it'll stick to your face. What do you do with your dog Woody at Christmas?
Well, I've stuck him behind the camera there.
And you love your dog. What did you make of the John Lewis advert with that dog on the trampoline?
The boxer?
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
Brilliant, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, we've got a Chatty Man exclusive from John Lewis. They've made a special version of the advert for Christmas Day just for us. Take a look at this.
One day I'll fly away, leave all this to yesterday. What more can your love do for me? When my heart be free?
I hope you kept the receipt, because this one's faulty. Amazing. Now, since I saw you last, you got an Oscar nomination for one of my favourite films of the last few years, The Revenant. What's the Oscars like?
I was completely out to lunch from jet lag. So when I got there, it was all a bit of a blur, to be fair. So I hid behind sunglasses.
Oh, I saw you, yeah. Oh, look at him, all cold with his sunnies on.
No, just red eyes.
Really?
it was brilliant. I never thought I'd end up going to the Oscars ever, to be fair. And I was a bit, so I was a bit shocked to be there. And then there's a couple of things that I didn't realise that they had. That inside the auditorium, if you go out to the toilet or the restroom or whatever, they immediately put somebody who looks like you in your seat.
Really?
Yeah.
They do that here. I went to the wee. Janet Street Porter was here when I came.
That was good.
What are you doing here? What are you doing, Janet? Get out of here. Now, listen. Everyone in Hollywood wants a slice of Tom Hardy the moment. They do.
Right.
So what's next for you? Wagwan.
What film?
Wagwan.
I'm just chilling at the moment. I'm having a bit of time off to be with the kids and put my feet up, and I'm being a bit of a dad.
Yeah. You know?
That's why I wore the jumper.
It's a lovely.
That's what dads do, don't they? Yeah. They wear jumpers.
Yeah.
Yes. some dads, anyway. I'm going to start filming another film, I think, in April. And then another one after that. And then I'll probably do another one after that. Here's the plan.
Yeah.
What do you think of that plan?
I love that plan.
It's not a bad plan. So that's the plan.
Can I just talk about CBeebies?
Oh, yes.
Now, I heard that you're...
Yes.
You said you're a dad there.
Yeah.
Now, you're reading a story on CBeebies.
Reading five.
You're reading five?
Yeah. Do you know what? I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed it.
Okay.
Like, I really,
yeah,
really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Like, because it's for kids, and I love my kids.
Yeah.
And
it's nice for you to do something that kids can watch.
It's better than Cowpole stories, yeah, is it? So if you can bore them, or send them off to sleep in a safe way. I think stories are a very healthy option.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I did do CBeebies because my kids can't watch me in anything.
Of course, oh, yeah.
So they don't think I have a job.
Yeah, that's on the craze, so can you, love all?
No, so I'm trying to teach them the value of money, and they're like, but you don't work. So I've done CBeebies in order to prove that I'm gainfully employed.
Yeah, good for you. Mm. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now, next month, you're going to be on screens in the big new BBC drama, Taboo. I saw it the other day, you know, and it is brilliant.
Thank you.
It's your baby, isn't it? You produced it, you starred in it.
Yeah, and it's a period drama.
It's gothic, it's got a real Dickensian feel about it. But what I love about it is it probably shows Victorian, so as it probably was. You know, there's whores everywhere, there's horse shit on the floor, people have teeth missing. It's like the Alan Carr story. Now, it's got a real darkness to it, isn't it?
It's dark, but it's not actually as dark as in... it's going to be a miserable show.
No,
you know what I mean?
No,
I think
people get a bit worried that it's supernatural.
Yeah, it's got some spooky, weird stuff going on. And the first one is quite gothic horror.
Yeah.
But then it unfolds into lots of different genres.
Without giving too much away, Tom, you play this character, he's come from Africa, isn't he? He's got secrets, isn't he?
A man of mystery.
He's a man of mystery.
In other words.
Yeah.
I play a guy who comes back from Africa.
Yeah.
But he returns from Africa after spending some time there.
Yeah.
And once he has returned, it's kind of mysterious.
Yeah.
Well, I can't tell you.
No, you can't tell me.
No.
It's to do with your dad and there's some land, isn't there?
Yeah.
I don't want to spoil it, but that's it, isn't it?
Yeah.
And there's a bit of supernatural in there and a bit of like Dickensian, Victorian, gothic.
Yeah, there's a bit of all sorts in there, from Jack the Ripper to Oliver Twist, and, you know, we've got a bit of Heart of Darkness and a little bit of Magwitch.
Yes,
who is that horrible convict on the moors in Great Expectations? So we read a couple of books when we wrote it.
Yeah, yeah.
For people that like these kinds
of
stories.
Yeah, everyone loves a bit of Dickens.
But there are some mysteries in it that I can't tell you.
No, of course.
But he comes back from Africa. At the very beginning, in the first episode.
Help.
And things have happened in Africa to him.
Mm.
And it's some spooky stuff.
Yeah.
But is it spookiness or...
Yeah. You're taking the piss now. Well, let's not have Tom Hardy on a loop. Let's have a look at you in action. This is Tom in an exclusive clip from the brilliant Taboo.
So, this small piece of land that my father bought for beads, bless him, and gunpowder some 30 years ago, actually, will be very, very valuable to the Crown and to the East India, but also incredibly valuable to the Americans.
Mr. Delaney, as a British subject, you owe a debt of loyalty to your king and country.
If patriotism is not in your motivation, Perhaps money can be. Before your unexpected return, we had agreed a figure with your half-sister. Her husband drove a particularly hard bargain.
Sorry, no, Nook Sound is not for sale.
Open the envelope.
Are you deaf?
Taboo is going out on BBC One on Saturday night. So how taboo and naughty can Taboo be compared to, say, Game of Thrones?
Oh, not as naughty as Game of Thrones. You can't have naughtiness like Game of Thrones on the BBC, unfortunately.
No.
And on FX, you can't show...
Yeah, bits and bobs.
Or you can't show... Yeah.
Mm,
you
know what I mean? Yeah.
You can't stab anyone or eat them or...
No.
You know, so it's quite hard to be taboo.
Yeah.
When you've got your hands tied.
Yeah.
Although, but it shouldn't be, you know, that's...
Yeah.
Paradoxically.
We're all naked under our clothes, even our Christmas jumpers, aren't we, Tom?
Yes.
I'll be honest with you, I really enjoyed the first episode, but I don't know much how longer I can watch it for, because earlier this year, some obscene images of Tom on set appeared in the papers. I mean, look at that, it's disgusting.
That's me on the way to CBeebies. Come your toys in there.
I mean, are you naked a lot in Taboo?
Well, technically, no, but it's not really a drama until someone gets their kit off or screams or gets covered in blood, is it?
Yeah, no, yeah.
You know what I mean? That's what we were taught at drama school. If in doubt, and you've got nothing to offer the world,
yeah.
Get naked, cover yourself in paint.
Yeah.
Cry, you know what I mean? Or just, like, you know, bang your head against the table, because that's drama. But when you get snot and vomit coming out of your nose...
Yeah.
Then you're a real method actor then, you know.
Oh.
Apparently.
Yeah.
But, you know, so we know it's a drama because I've got my arse out.
Yeah. But there won't be any more scenes like that, will there? Because I just find
every
it disgusting.
Day, there was Naked Mondays. Every week, sorry, there was a Naked Monday.
Yeah.
And her job was, I was naked,
yeah.
And I had to walk around in the water in Tilbury, or in the woods.
Yeah.
Because it was just, yeah, but it was just...
You really...
It was so cold, and it was like, it felt so good. There were people there to watch me, and none of it was going to go on screen. It was just purely for pleasure. What's wrong with that?
January 7th it starts.
Yeah, January 7th for 8 weeks.
Ah, it is absolutely brilliant. Honestly, check it out. Give it up for Tom Hardy, everyone. Robbie Williams, Gary Barlow, Danny Minogue and Martin Kemp will be here in a bit, and Tom Daly and the cast of Star Wars will be dropping by later, but don't go anywhere, because after the break, Queen of the Jungle, Scarlett Moffat, will be dropping by. I'll see you in part two.